freshly cut fairways, manicured greens, challenging hazards, all combined with the joy of being outdoors around nature. There are over 16,000 golf courses in the United States, and most of them are places of relative quiet. But by the thousands every year, golfers flock to a course in Indiana called Brickyard Crossing, where tranquility can be secondary.
Gentlemen, start your engine!
This is the Indianapolis 500,
the greatest spectacle in racing.
The excitement watching them go 230 miles an hour makes the hair on the back of your neck stand up.
Though the Indianapolis Motor Speedway officially opened in 1909 and hosted its first 500-mile race in 1911, golf has been played inside and outside the famous oval track for the last 93 years, and not just by committed golfers, by race car drivers.
Parnelly Jones was a good player. Tell you who was really a good player was Jackie Stewart, the Scottish player. He was probably the lowest handicap. When Roger Ward and Lloyd Ruby were of the drivers, Jim Rathman always thought he was.
I'll tell you who was really good. It was Jim Garner.
The biggest names probably were Garner and Paul Newman and those kind of people.
Even before one of their historic concerts, the Beatles hung out at what is now known as Brickyard Crossing. In those earlier years, there were 9 holes inside the track and 18 outside. But in 1992, world-renowned golf architect Pete Dye renovated the course, turning it into an 18-hole layout and leaving 4 holes inside, holes 7 through 10. Before and after that change, some of golf's biggest names played there in prominent PGA and LPGA Tour events. Billy Casper, Gary Player, and Mickey Wright all won here. And just 5 years ago, so did Lexi Thompson. And also playing that course, growing up inside and outside, was race and golf promoter Jim Cook's son, John, later himself an 11-time winner on the PGA Tour.
The teachers would load me up with homework, and I would go get to spend 2 weeks with my dad playing golf and hanging out. You know, kind of going to driver's meetings and going in the pits and, you know, into the garage. I mean, it was a thrill for a young boy into a teenager.
Perhaps you're wondering, after you've played the first 6 holes and it's time to go inside the track for the next 4, how do you do it?
So there's a tunnel that goes underneath, I'm gonna say just out of turn 2, just down the back straight, and it goes under the speedway, and there you go. Now you're inside the track. And there's numbers 7T and 7 green.
12 years ago on that number 7, George Franchitti teed off on that 181-yard par 3 and aced it. And later that week, his son Dario took the checkered flag on the other side of the track. There's a tradition that the winning driver gets a lifetime membership at the golf course, but Dario already had that from winning the race in 2007. Oh, maybe you have an awful slice and you're thinking, if you play a shot near a racetrack, could a ball go astray?
No, I don't think so. I think the 10th hole, if you get one like 60, 80 yards offline from right to left, maybe. You'd have to aim it there, I guess, if you really wanted to hit one on the track. And I think that if you aimed one there, you might be escorted off. I think that's frowned upon, trying to hit it on the track.
The course normally opens in April and closes in October. In season, it only closes one day, race day, when some 10,000 fans will be gathered on the golf course park to celebrate this greatest spectacle in racing. For years, there was an annual drivers' tournament, but as their time became more compressed each May, the event ended in the 1990s. It's very possible an ownership change may actually increase the course's schedule in the future.
It's a celebrity in a way. Now owns the Motor Speedway is Roger Penske. And Roger was very much interested in golf. Now that he owns it, I would think that he'll be very interested in, you know, seeing that golf course develop like he does other things that he gets involved with.
Although the course is booked solid right now, if you're considering Brickyard Crossing, the fee for a round is $175. But hear this review from a pro who has played on several continents.
And once you get through that tunnel and go into that seventh tee and you look up, this is 2.5 miles of structure and pavement. And it is just spectacular. You look around and you're just going, man, I don't believe where I am right now. You're playing into the grandstands. See the tower, the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, and the history of what's gone on there. And now there's a golf course that you can play that goes outside and inside and back outside. There's nowhere in the world that you can experience something like this.
Inside the 2.5 mile oval, you could place Churchill Downs, Yankee Stadium, Michigan Stadium, the Rose Bowl, the Vatican, and 4 holes of an historic golf course. But on race day, not those structures at that track, just 300,000 fans.